third bout of the evening, getting ready to get going. Here it is, Hugo Katsanovas taking on Abakan Bokhti of Oshawa, Ontario. As you can see, the stats for Hugo Daniel Katsanovas, a 3-1 record, 2 knockouts in his professional career. Again, Hugo, he's got that knockout power that obviously the fans are going to be looking to after 2 draws to open up the evening, Michelle.
I would say that's unlucky 2 draws, but at the same time, as we mentioned, it's just, you know, the fighters coming here and going after it. Coming in here and just doing their thing.
Please welcome Abakan Bokhti.
Keep a wishing for a burner.
Here comes Abakan Bokhti, a 2-0 professional record. His second appearance inside of the Hershey Center. It was a win over Shavar Henry in a unanimous decision. He is looking to make, again, a serious impact in his third professional bout here against Hugo Katsanovas.
And I guess you could say this is the battle of the veterans. You know, Bokhti being 37 years of age and Katsanovas 32 years old. I mean, 32 years old isn't that old, but just compared to Valdivia, the 23-year-old, we have another 23-year-old on the card coming up as our co-main event in Cody Crawley. These guys are the vets of United Promotions.
A small town boy is Bokhti out of Oshawa, Ontario. I'll tell you, they breed them well down there, certainly. This is a towering presence, just so much confidence pouring off the body of Bokhti here. Making his way into the squared circle.
Dixie Hyundai and Cambridge Hyundai proudly present this 4-round contest in the Cruiserweight Division. Your judges for this bout are Mr. Jeremy Hayes, Mr. Harry Davis, and Dr. Marvin Cezanne. When the bell sounds, your third man in the ring, the referee, is Mr. Mark Simmons. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing gold trimmed with purple, his professional record, 3 wins, only 1 defeat, 2 wins coming by way of knockout. From Buenos Aires, Argentina, weighing 198.8 pounds, Hugo Storm Katsanovas. And his opponent fighting out of the red corner, wearing all white. He is undefeated in the pro ranks, 2 wins, no losses. From Oshawa, Ontario, weighing 196.1 pounds, Abakan the Atomic Bokhti.
Boxers, we went over the instructions in the dressing room. I want a good, clean fight. When I say break, you step back, you stop punching, protect yourself at all times. Anything under here is low. Anything under here is low. Touch gloves. Good luck to the both of you.
Okay, if this one ends in a draw, I'd be shocked. That was an intense stare down. I love it. I love this sport.
So we're taking a look at the numbers here. Abakan Bokhti against Hugo Katsanovas. This should be a lot of fun here.
One thing to mention about Bokhti, usually he is just so much bigger in terms of length, taller and longer than all of his opponents, but Katsanovas seems to be right there toe-to-toe in terms of size.
Not a significant reach advantage.
landing heavy on that overhand right.
A lot of power behind the hands.
Especially,
Bakby.
Yeah, Bakby being a southpaw as well. So it's tough to contend with, but you're also more susceptible to the overhand right, even more so.
A lot of action on our side here. And you've seen that tonight with our southpaws, using the right to really set up that left.
Casanova's looking kind of like Colin Farrell right now. I was like, he looks...
I wasn't going to say it, but...
You can already hear from Bakby's corner saying right down the pipe, because everything so far Casanovas has thrown has literally been these wild flailing punches, all looping punches. And he's already been warned about punching to the back of the head as well.
I think and he was warned about that low blow shot there to Bakby. Hands are just flailing here early on in this contest. Shot from Bakby. You know, our main event is the Battle of Ontario, Storino, but, you know, an underlining rivalry that we have happening here tonight is a little bit of that Canada, North America versus South America feel to it. You got a lot of fighters on this card from Argentina, Mexico. That is certainly something to look out for as we continue on here tonight. Looks like there's a small mouse there over the left eyebrow of Bakby. Good look at the cut. And the Oshawa native, and that'll do it. Exciting opening round there.
Casanovas is swinging for the fences with every single punch. My goodness, you know where he's going all the time as well. So that is definitely an advantage, I think, for Bakby, because you know what he's coming with you, coming at you with. So if you could sustain that and be able to throw a couple straight hands down the pipe while he's looping those and trying to get to you, because remember, he is still the bigger, longer fighter, and he's also southpaw, so he's got to get past, Casanovas has to get past that long right arm of Bakby before he can loop around and do anything else.
Well, as we mentioned, Bakby hasn't been at the pro game too long. It has just been 3 years since he broke out on the professional ranks. He had 28 amateur fights before turning pro, debuting in April of 2014 with a split decision win over a man that is on this card tonight. We are, of course, talking about Lyndon Chambers at the Royal York Hotel in Toronto.
And now Bakby's switched stances, too, so he's fighting now orthodox. Maybe trying to combat the fact that he's getting that overhand, and but you got to keep that left hand up. You know, you got to, if it's not up, you got to pump it out and get that jab going. That's it.
I like that, pump it out.
Sorry. <'Cause> your jab does so many things.
Those over-the-top shots there from Casanovas.
Continuing on that wavelength, your jab does so many things. It's a starting point to see your distance. It's a use of deflection. So, you know, sometimes you just don't want your opponent to see what's up, so you're just gonna have your hand out there the whole time, kind of gauging it, gauging your distance, having it, using it as a distraction. Then, of course, you can use it, obviously, as offense to set up other punches, and you use it for defense to keep fighters at bay.
Everybody just tuning in, welcome into Championship Boxing on Rogers TV. Kyle Liberto, Michelle Storino bringing you all the action here tonight. Our third bout of the evening here on Rogers TV. It is Abakan Bakpi in the white trunks. You've got Hugo Casanovas out of Argentina in the gold and maroon.
Bakpi's gone back to southpaw. And that cut has definitely opened up a little bit more, Kyle. As you can see, there's some blood spatter on his shorts.
Michelle, you've been doing this a long time. Any blood come this way? Because I do need to get prepared.
Yes. My prep sheets have been splattered, to say the least. Never my clothing, though, so if that's any help.
Minimizing the dry cleaning bill for sure. We see some action here in our corner. Casanovas, some big rights. It's our official for this contest, bringing him back in the middle. Again with that huge over-the-top shot there. Go big or go home from the Argentinian. Once again. That awkward sneeze there from Casanovas over the top, bullying Bakpi there into the ropes late in that round. How do you score that one?
And you can see here, you know, like even though he is throwing these, you know, looping shots and kind of going for gold and swinging for the fences, whatever kind of cliche you want to use for it, Kyle, is that he's still landing them either way. He's still landing some pretty big shots. And, you know, if he's not getting him cleanly with an overhand, he's following it up with some body shots as well. And he's really putting Bakpi kind of off balance. And really, he's not doing anything offensively. Anything he's doing is purely defensively and kind of keeping him at bay or, you know, counterpunching. He's not really on the offensive himself. He just keeps moving backwards. And you could see, when you're on defense, folks, it's more tiring than when you're the one producing all the offense and throwing punches and bunches, if you will.
Let's get the second half of this bout underway here. Three of four rounds in this cruiserweight division. In the chin there, Casanovas. Bakpi taking full advantage. Big right from Casanovas. Bakpi toying with him a little bit, saying that's all you got.
Both guys playing to the crowd a little bit as well.
Both really animated fighters in this contest. Certainly my vote for fight of the night up to this point. Big left.
Bakpi keeps switching stances here to try to scrub Casanova a little bit.
Thunderous right. See that versatility a little bit in Bakpi's game.
Yeah, Bakpi's mouth is open, he's breathing heavily as well. We still have a minute and a half to go in this third round, so a lot of time left.
We saw that a little earlier in the fight from the way Casanovas as well.
Casanovas right is doing a great job of, you know, this is the definition of dirty boxing here, kind of laying on your opponent, trying to get those, you know, shorts, you know, short hooks or small uppercuts into the body as well. And just leaning on your opponent, because your weight, on top of the fact that they have to defend themselves, is exhausting. Bakpi needs to put some combos together. Here he goes.
Thunderous shots, and he is pumped. This fight is over. Hugo Hugo Casanovas having a hard time getting back up on his feet with some thunderous shots from Abakan Bakpe. Give him 3 wins now on his professional fight career. Wow, what an impact and a statement made tonight, Michelle, from the Oshawa, Ontario native. Get a load of this right here. Stumbling, doesn't know where he is. And then Bakpe putting the final touches on what was a very convincing win. From the man in the all-white trunks, another look at it, another angle there. Just some power and blows from the Canadian. Well, the draw streak, Storino, came to an abrupt end.
Yes,
right there.
I think everyone is pretty happy about that other than Casanovas. Yeah.
Casanovas still having a hard time getting back up on his feet, finally does. Still a little wobbly there, looking to give some love to the opposition right now, but they're not letting him. They're sitting him right down, ice on the neck.
You know, we saw both fighters.
Well, that picture says it all right there. But if you take a look, this is what happened just moments before that knockout. A huge right to the way of Abakan Bakpe.
How can you know, it's, they're both guys were playing to the crowd. They both took massive shots earlier in that round. And now, you know, he comes back, finishes with a left hook in his normal southpaw stance. And it seemed as though Casanovas was, you know, backing up, and he was tired. He was already shaken up. And that initial jab set up the rockiness, and he just finished it off with that left hook.
That is one happy camper. We will give the official decision over to Patrick Mono.
Ladies and gentlemen, the fight is stopped at 2 minutes 25 seconds of round number 3. The winner by knockout, Abakan the Atomic Bakpe!
The elder statesman, Abakan Bakpe, with his 3rd professional win in the great sport of boxing. And we're gonna take a look, as quick pose there from Bakpe.